guys, we're back with Carson. And, you know, it's very, very important. What you don't want to do with this old dog is rub their head and all that. They don't want that. This dog, if we can find somebody, Eva, I hope you can find somebody that will just, this is what she wants. She doesn't want her thought sights. They don't want their face obstructed. I don't understand why people do that. You know, if you want a dog to be interested, you've got to be interested. Anyway, I've got the vibrating collar on her, so what this does is just, it's just basically like a cell phone. And I, you know, people say they use it to get the dog to look at you, but it's way, way beyond that. Oh, you precious angel. Understand when you say that, all right? Stay on it. All right, here's my pager. I'm holding it down. And then I've got a very deliberate way of being indifferent after I get the trick. That's how you're gonna keep them coming back for more. Well, she's a good, good little dog, though, girl. I gotta run oil for her coat. Oh, all her special little meals that she gets. They don't need to hear this dog, you know. And honestly, if you didn't tell me it was deaf, it would probably take me a while to figure it out. Because especially with other dogs, you know, they model the behavior anyway. But I mean, do you see how the less interested I am, the more interested she is? And I could definitely, you definitely want to do this too, girl. All right, now watch. I'm going to bring her back this way. Holding it down. Oh,
she's holding it down.
Yeah. Oh, look at her go.
Look at her.
So we had already started the platform the other day. So this is what's going to get her. You know, and again, I'm not looking. I would get the dog up there and start trying to get crazy signals to sit. That wouldn't be as good as her believing that that's what she wants to do. All right, there's my hand movements again. She understands that. All right, here's my pager. Holding it down.
Yay!
You want to move around a lot. I don't know if they even understand running in place. They just, oh, it's moving.
It's moving.
You know, and I'm fairly certain we'll probably be able to get her laying down. You know, but for right now, and if you can, you know, and I'm going to show you with that little black boxer. Because these dogs, if they've got those big eyes, they'll look right at you. And if you start petting their head, I'll tell you, they stop looking. They stop looking and they start biting and barking. Am I wrong?
Yay.
If you think it can't understand.
Yay.
I always do it. You know, when she first sees you, she'll wag. And then you have to wag back. It just, you know, that's the caveat of this. All right, so watch me do my page and go away. There's my hand movement. Here's my pager. Precious angel. And not that I'm even that worried about Sid, but you know, if I've kind of strung that together, you know, if you think more than anything a valuable quality in a deaf dog is one that's made it their mission to watch you. All right, so there's my hand, there's my pager. Different about that one, the way the arms operate. Yeah. obvious. If I want this dog to understand I'm leaving, and even if it's, you know, I think it's better with the open hand where you're just... Exact same thing by taking the exact path up there. She's like Coco the monkey. I mean, if you don't have them trying to, I can watch. I'm going to bend my arm when she sits. It's got the arm again acts differently. People do it all the time. Oh, look, I'm going to do my pager, and then I'm going to have my big hand signal. I'm going to tell you, and this is maybe what it is, Chelsea. Not that we're always going away from the dog, but that there seems to be a deliberate putting that individual out of your eye line. All right, watch. She's going to go the same way. Watch. Precious, precious little dog. You know, and I mean, she believes this is what she wants to do. And if you said, well, how can you model the behavior that she's doing? I would say something like, then there's a very deliberate way that my arm goes back. And you know, and if you said, where are you operating the dog from right here? That's what Hanky doing. You know, that's what I want. Understand every signal I give is coming from there, and if you said it's coming from your heart, in some ways, yeah, it is. That is. Alright, now look, I'm gonna do the crumbs are getting everywhere. Alright, watch, I'm gonna do my pager, and that was kind of just a sleight of hand. I'm gonna do my pager now. Let me see if I can. I'm going to add a little signal. There's my pager. I'm going to do the double fold and she's going to sit. Watch. Stop. Say to herself that worked. I can assure you she did. She says that worked. And I'm going to tell you, with a dog like this, it takes time for them to understand that it works. Because the other humans they encountered, they didn't work so good. They were working. Am I wrong, someone? They weren't that good. They gave it the treat and then thump, thump, thump. All right, now watch. She's going to watch my hand. Back up there, watch. Precious. All right, watch. She's gonna double hand. I have a very deliberate way of pulling my hand over. Anyway, Michelle, she's just doing awesome. I love this little dog so much. I will never forget this little dog. And I'm gonna tell you why. Because I always talk about dogs that play the affable card, but this actually really is an affable dog. And it isn't as common. I don't think it's common at all. It isn't common at all. So we've got to make sure that, I mean, she doesn't need any thumping or, you know, know, if you said you could better communicate by thumping, not you, I'm just talking to people in general, the dog's ribs and stuff, I was, and she's watching me, and that's, you know, just letting her default to my watch. So basically, you got to learn the Macarena. What was the Macarena? Do you remember, Summer? It was like...
Yeah. When you flip up on stuff.
Oh, Summer knew it perfect.
I know
it,
yeah.
Oh, I bet you kids did it all bad. The time, didn't you? And then what, you did? You crossed
the skating ring and stuff.
Oh, they had a skating Macarena. Yeah, but where I think, you know, we'll be able to get her laying down the way you would probably do that. Let's start. This is a tremendous thing. I don't have to go today. If you want a dog to stay by you,
her tail like goes in a helicopter. It goes in a circle. It's funny.
He actually is an affable dog. He's not just pretending, because there is such a thing as dogs that'll play the affable card. Oh, look, she's getting that bone. Oh, she loves bones. She loves bones. Wait till she goes away. You know, but she chooses to stay by me. And I'm just going to tell you why. Because I'm interesting because of the way I act. It's not because of the treats. It really isn't.
No.
You know, honestly, I mean, it's just like anybody, if you start being too interested in them,
see you later.
What happens? Yeah. It's smothering. You know, I think if you talk to a lot of dogs, they say, oh, God, they smother me. All right, guys, we gotta go.